G'day guys, I've spent a lot of the past few days going through the latest update to Don't Starve Together, Eye of the Storm, and I can tell you, I'm not all that much closer to understanding what the hell is going on with the return of them, but I can show you all the new things in this update and explain how they work, so that's what I'm going to do. As always, keep in mind that what I'm about to show you is from the beta branch, so it's still subject to changes and adjustments, or even new additions, all of which I will leave in a pinned comment below. So, first things first, remember the mysterious energy that showed up when you socket all of the lunar altars and tributes and things on the moon? Yeah, that looks a bit different now. Once you've completed the set on the moon, you'll very quickly notice some changes, most obvious of which is the triggering of some kind of super full moon that will last until the end of the current day, and then will occur again each night. Like the normal kind of full moon, werepigs will be around, the moonstone will be usable, Glomma will return to its statue, and so on. But that's not all. On the mainland, there are now moonstorms, which are kind of similar to sandstorms that you get in the Oasis Desert in summer, except a bit more hostile. In these storms, there are lightning strikes known as energetic static that creates these mineable collections of infused moon shards. You'll also notice these glowing moon gleams that can shock you for 10 damage if you get too close, but you can catch them with a bug net. And last but not least, in the moonstorm, you can come across a very familiar face. It's Wagstaff. Upon first meeting Wagstaff, he will give you two blueprints. One for astral goggles to help you see in the moonstorm, and one for an incomplete experiment, which you'll see requires restrained static. And this is collected by helping out Wagstaff. His transmission in the moonstorm continues to bounce around a bit until he's found the source of a reading he's been searching for. Once he's honed in on it, you'll need to help him build the device by gathering nearby tools for him, and defend it from the onslaught of mutated birds. These birds only have 10 health each, but can shoot projectiles at Wagstaff that deal 20 damage, and considering this device only has 100 health in total, it can't really afford to be hit that many times. Also, be careful using weather paints to help you with this, because you can actually destroy the device yourself. Completing this will give you one restrained static, and you'll need to do this at least twice. But now we can start building the incomplete experiment for Wagstaff. This must be placed on top of the mysterious energy, and it's one of those constructions that you need to complete in a few stages, kind of like Pearl's house or the royal tapestry, so you might need to go back and forth a bit, but once you finish it, you can summon the new boss, the Celestial Champion. Now, I really like this fight because it incorporates a lot of elements of fights against other bosses and creatures, making it almost an amalgamation of sorts, which is fitting because the boss itself is made from the loot and hard work of several different events and quests. The fight comes in three stages, with each stage having more health than the next, starting at 10,000. In the first stage, all you really need to do is dodge the rolling attack by running in triangles, which reminds me a lot of how the Snortuses attack in the Forge. Following this, the champion will stomp the ground at least four times, after which you can get a good number of hits in. Every now and then, it will dig itself into the ground and release a bunch of gestalts that will try to put you to sleep, but you can just stand at a safe distance and wait. Rinse and repeat until phase two. Now here's where it gets a little bit tricky. The main attack in this stage is a lot like that of the Skitter Squids, and it's much harder to dodge than the rolling move. And if you don't have a hefty speed boost like me with my overcharge and walking cane, you might want to consider using a Lazy Explorer instead. After this, the champion will either send waves of gestalts after you or make a wall of moonglass spikes. Both of these are fairly easy to dodge by heading in a circle around the boss. It's also worth noting that both the rolling and propeller attacks can chop down trees, so you could potentially use this to your advantage, either by getting a lot of logs, or possibly getting tree guards to help you out in the fight. In the final phase, the Celestial Champion will spawn enlightening snares around itself, kind of like how Toadstool spawns mush trees around itself, except as far as I can tell, these don't give the boss any kind of buff. They just make you fall asleep if you get hit a few times by the energy that comes off it. You can counter this by eating cooked moon shrooms or mushy cake, or by destroying the snares with a pickaxe or weather pane, or you could just avoid them. At this stage, the boss likes to do laser attacks, akin to that of the Winter's Feast Deerclops, and they hurt a lot. So having bone armor would definitely make things a lot more manageable at this point in the fight. After the ranged attack, you can get in a few hits. Every now and then the boss will summon a ring of defenses. Staying in the ring is pretty dangerous, and since there's no real penalty for leaving and waiting, I suggest doing just that. This boss also has a melee attack that's fairly easy to dodge, but it's worth pointing out that these attacks, and in fact most of the attacks from all stages of this boss, do a ton of damage, so even if you're comfortable kiting, you really should come prepared either with health or extra armor or both. Probably both. After defeating the final phase of the boss, Wagstaff returns and thanks you for your help before the transmission fades out. Amongst all the rubble from mining the remains, you can find an enlightened crown, which grants a whopping 10 sanity per minute, making it an even greater source of sanity than a TAM. Not to mention the fact that it never wears out. It also gives you a source of light about as big as a lantern when you have more than 85% sanity, and summons gestalts that hit your targets for around 40 damage when you have a high level of sanity as well. Besides this hat, all of the pieces of the altars are given back to allow you to do the fight again if you wish. Oh, and you probably noticed that it's nighttime now. Don't worry, the lights out is not permanent, but the lunar calendar does get shifted from completing this fight. The day you finish becomes a new moon, and 10 days after will be a full moon, replacing the old dates. And besides that, not much is really gained from this fight just yet. You do get a figure sketch as well as a bunch of moon shards, but it's a heck of a lot of effort to go through to set up this fight, and I'm not quite sure if the crown justifies it at this stage. Like I said, we may get more from this at a later date, and there seems to be more to come from the return of them as well, so who knows? We still need to find out what's going on with the sealed portal in the archives. Not much is really explained about what Wagstaff hopes to gain from this either, but I get the impression that it wasn't exactly from the kindness of his heart, you know. It seems as though he had rather self-serving intentions. And this does have some implications on the lore side of things as well, which I will leave for another video, but it's getting pretty spicy. But yeah, interesting times. As always, I'd love to hear your thoughts on this update. Do you like the boss? Do you think the crown is enough? And what do you think is coming next? Either way, I will see you then. Take care.